Hello and welcome to the shop. It's an exciting day today because we're going to be gluing up boxes. What you see are all the parts for the boxes, including the lids that are dry fitted together. In the front are the parts for the box sides and then the bottoms and a dry fitted box over on the right. And I am Dave Klein. Let's get started. What I'm going to do first is get things ready to go. One of the big problems is that there's a risk of gluing the bottom panel into the grooves and then it might crack. So to avoid that, I rub the edges with a piece of paraffin wax, and that stops the glue from bonding to the edges and then maybe a little bit on the tops and the bottoms. If you're doing a large batch, this gets a little bit tedious. So you can use a product called Anchor Seal. It's emulsified paraffin. They use it in spray booths to keep the spray finishes, lacquer and varnish and stuff, from sticking to the walls. It's expensive, but it's a really good product. So here we have the bottom panels ready to go. I've dry fitted everything. I've taken time with a little sanding board to go in and deburr all the inside pieces, make sure everything's a good fit. I've gone through a dry clamping process to test all that, and the time is ready to start the glue up. There's a lot of ways to do this. Just a couple of points. I use Tight Bond 3 glue. The shop temperature is over 60 degrees. All the wood is warm. It's over 60 degrees. I warm things up over the wood stove. If that's an issue for you, it's something to be aware of. I start by putting glue on one side, and then I build the box up from that part, dry fit it together. These are blocks I put inside the box. You'll see that, and then I clamp it together. That way I can ensure that it's square without worrying about trying to measure diagonals over the clamps. So let's just get started and see how it goes. The glue is warm and fitting into the, soaking into the surfaces. So this is the back corner. So as I put the glue in, I try to get them dry fitted or fitted so that the glue isn't drying because of the air circulation around it. Getting glue on these inside edges because that really helps hold it together. Once I get one started, I move it to the next one. And it's just kind of boring, but getting all of these surfaces coated with glue. Trying to use a clean brush to make sure there's no glue in the groove. Get the panel is raised on the bottom, and so we're getting this slid into the groove. It's a nice fit. Now we have to be very careful about not getting glue on the bottom. So I'm going to avoid putting any glue in that slot. And then after it's dry fitted together, I wiggle a little bit in from the outside. Trying to get it on these inside surfaces. And moving just quickly, but not recklessly. A little bit there. And then lastly, on the surface. So now the glue's in it. I have these spacers I use to keep it up off the workbench. That allows the clamps to get positioned better. Then I put spacers. I'm going to just make sure there's no glue coming out of the corners right yet. I put spacers inside, and we'll talk about the spacers in a minute. The benefit of these is that it keeps the box square, which is critical to get the fit for the lid. These two pieces are taller because it's easier to pull them out. And then I use, they're not too tight, and I use spacers. And it's critical the spacers are in these locations, because I'm going to be clamping here and I want it to pinch the corners. So we're getting pretty close. I put these calls, they're about an eighth inch in. And I use these Wetzler's clamps because they're really strong. And I pull that together. Outside so that the Yorkies fit on the inside. You can see that it's not quite square, so I'm wiggling it around. I have some putty knives so you can get in, I can see an even space. The edges are snug and the spaces on the front and the back are even. Then I want to pinch the corner joint tight, and I use these Jorgensens to do that. You can see the gap here, and that pulls it tight. And what you're looking for is even squeeze out. So this back piece and the front piece right now are shaped a little bit like this, and that pinches the corners tight. It's square because we know the plugs are square, and that's all you have to do. That's how you set up and glue a box. It's reliable, and it's not a problem to do 10 boxes in an hour, hour and a half, if you have enough clamps. I usually do 5 or 6. I run out of clamps, I let them sit for an hour, and then I do the second 5 or 6. And that's it. I'll get set up and we'll talk about gluing up lids. Well, here's the lid all dry fitted. I'm going to take it apart. We're going to put the paraffin on the panels, corners. try to get some of that on the tops and bottoms of the panel tongue. Now, doing the glue, I'm going to get it inside the slot or the mortise on the tenon, avoiding the groove for the panel, and sliding it in place, and then we'll talk about clamping. I get on the surface and on the corner where it pinches into the slot, because that's what people notice. Also some glue on the shoulder, but not a lot. I don't want a lot of squeeze out, but I want that snug. And like doing the box, I try to work one corner at a time. Once you have that, I'm going to work this side. Work it up here. Of course, it's important to keep it off the panel. So I work around the panel, getting it in the bottom, shoulder, and on the top. Want the panel to be centered, but we're going to pinch it across the top first to get the two shorter pieces pulled in against the edge of the panel so that everything is parallel and square. To do that, I use these 5/8 inch spacers. I get the clamps close to the corners, the joints there, and I'm not using a lot of force. It doesn't take much force to pull this stuff together. And then I come from underneath and that's where you see things snug up front to back. Now that I've got that, I take the spacers out, I slide the whole thing close to the edge so that I can get the smaller clamps. I put spacers on the top and the bottom. The spacers have tape on them so that they don't glue to the lid. Out so that the handles don't hit the bench. get everything aligned just right. Get the panels, get the clamps parallel. Snug it down. That gives a nice pinch. And now I can lift it up off the blocks. Spin it around and do these other two corners. That's it. A little awkward, but I got it. Hi, we're back on the jewelry box. It's been in the clamps for about 2 hours, and we're going to pull the clamps off, and I'm going to show you how this plug works to keep everything square, and look to see about the results. Also sand the edges to see how that evens up the outside. So the point of these plugs is to keep the box square and the glue up without having to measure the diagonals. It works better to have the pieces vertical rather than horizontal because they're easier to get out after the thing is glued up. And these shims help because they give just a little bit of wiggle room to get all the parts out. Let's get a little bit of glue. And here are the glue joints. Looks pretty good. Glue gob there. And the bottom, you can hear it. It wiggles just a little bit, so I know that it didn't get glued into place. And so now we're going to go over to these pieces of MDF screwed to the workbench. I'm going to take the box, I'm going to put it here. These are just a little bit, maybe a 64th, rised above the surface, and we're going to sand that down. We'll do the two ends this way, and we'll do the front and back on this one. And let's do that now. I'm using a Bosch belt sander. It's very old, and it's got maybe some 180 grit sandpaper. And this is how the glue joints, if it'll focus in a minute here. That's what you want for a glue joint. I'm going to give it a minute to focus. Let me just wipe this off. I need a little bit more sanding, but that's what I'm aiming for. And then the sides. Try and show this. Front and side. Just a quick note on cleaning up the interior. I don't know if you can see that. The glue that you get a little bit of squeeze out in the interior corners. The way I clean that up is by taking a rag with very warm water and a putty knife and going down and scraping that out. The warm water helps, but it raises the grain and you have to come back and sand it. But that is what I have found works best. And then I come back with a sanding block that is shaped like a diamond. If I can show that. This is a sanding block for the inside corners. You wrap your sandpaper around it. And then I'm going to just show you quickly in a corner that doesn't have the water taken out. And you just use the sanding block vertically, like this and like this, to clean up the inside corner. And that's about it. And here's the lid. It's been in the clamps for a couple hours. I'm going to get the clamps off. You can see there's a little bit of glue out, but you can see the bridle joints have come together pretty well. I don't sand these. It's a snug fit, a little bit of glue, but they go through the wide belt sander, and then I shave them with a hand plane, and that cleans up the corners pretty well. And then, of course, the critical issue is fitting them to the box, and we'll do that in the next video. So thank you for watching, and the next video we'll fit the lids, put the strike plate on the lid, connect it to the lock, and get set up for hinges.